This is an example of nature sort of doing its worst. And so we have this invasive species first seen in 2019 on Vancouver Island. And we haven't seen them on Vancouver Island in a long time, but they seem to have set up shop right at the border between Washington and BC, right at the edge of the continent where Blaine and White Rock meet. And so last year there were 31 sightings in Washington state. Half of those were made by the public, half of those were made by officials. 6 sightings in BC, all of those made by the public, but none so far in 2021 until now. And so now we have our first sighting of the year, and it just shows that the eradication of these things has not been complete and that the battle is still afoot.
Yeah, certainly is. How invasive are these species to our Canadian bees?
Well, it's so hard to say. So these things, we don't exactly know how they got to North America.
Okay.
But the most probable is some kind of scenario involving a shipping container or a boat, because it's at the coast where the ocean is. And their native habitat is in Asia. So perhaps a boat coming across from Asia to the west coast of North America is how they got here. And then in terms of them setting up shop, there aren't very many of them to find. And so many people in the public, especially beekeepers, have set up traps to try to catch these things, mm-hmm. and they alert officials as soon as they see them. And so if there were a lot of them, we would be getting a lot of sightings because people are really watching for them, and they're very easy to spot. I mean, they're huge, right? They're 2 inches long, 5 centimeters, very conspicuous, and they come after bees' nests or wasp nests. And what they do is they attack those colonies, and they actually rip the heads off of the workers from the bee colony and carry them back to their own nest to feed their young. And so they're pretty aggressive. But it's unclear whether these things are going to take off and just spread across North America, which
right.
potentially they could do, or if we're going to manage to keep this genie in the bottle, so to speak, and manage to keep their numbers down. There was a very sort of public destruction of a hive, of a mm-hmm. nest of these things in October, and everybody was very excited to see that. But it doesn't, I mean, there were 200 in that, 200 queens
wow.
in that nest, 500 individuals. And so you can see it wouldn't take much for one nest to become many.
Yeah, no, exactly. So, of course, we know now that they're going to be tracking, you know, and tracking that hornet back to the nest there. What do they need to do to say, all right, we've officially taken care of it?
Well, so, I mean, what they're saying is they'd like to do that. They've got
yeah.
a picture of one, and it's gone now. And so they don't know which way it flew. So, I mean, people who live in that part of the world, you're being asked to watch for the hornet, but then when it leaves, watch which way it goes. And the way that most people set up their hornet nests kills the hornets. They land in basically fruit juice at the bottom of an empty pop bottle. But the people for the government are trying to set those up so that they stay alive and they can put a radio tag on them. So they have successfully radio tracked these things in the past. That is the plan going forward. But
yeah.
really, eradication of these things, or even just control of them, really relies on the public keeping an eye open. And so if you're in that part of the world, and goodness knows, even if you're not,
yeah.
it's great to pay attention to what insects you're seeing around, especially if you have bee colonies on your property or even a wasp nest. Just keep an eye open. And if you see something unusual, announce it and report it, because it's the best way that the authorities have to control these things.
Well, if I see one, I will take a quick picture. I will let you know, and then I'm going the other way.
Yeah, that sounds like a perfect set of ways to handle it. So
there
let's
go.
Do that. Let's
Dan
agree on
Ruskin,
that.
Dan Ruskin, so good to have you on the program, CTV Science and Technology Specialist. Enjoy your weekend, Dan.
Thank you so much. You too.